The great thing about our Live Kind initiative, Kindness Initiative, is that it's not a program, it's a language, it's a way of life. And so that's what we hope for our students and for our students that are growing to be young women and young men in our community, is that we want to spread kindness and make it their way of life. And so it's not a program, it's how they feel on the inside, and it's how they live their life.
Sing to me, baby, in your native tongue. Sing the words of the wise and the young. Show me the place where your words come from. Love's a language, love's your native tongue.
You know, it's interesting. I think that most of us kind of have an intuitive sense that the logic is sound when we say relationships are important, when we say kindness matters, when we talk about kids feeling connected to adults. We all instinctively feel that that's correct, but it's cool when the science backs it up.
In the principal's office, we saw less office referrals. In the counselor's office, the number one thing that kids usually come to me for is friend issues or someone feeling like they're being picked on. And that was not the case last year. We were thinking, what is going on? And it was all because of our kindness initiative.
It gave kids an opportunity to talk about what was on their heart, and we had some heavy things on our hearts this year. We had grandparents that passed away, and we had children that had to move, and it gave them a chance to see that their friend might look the same on the outside, but their heart was carrying something.
One of the things that we did see is that at the beginning of the year, we were at one level, and by the end of the year, that number had moved. You know, that those campuses that gave it at the beginning and gave it at the end were able to see some growth.
The time that we spend on Live Kind in our district, we get back so much more in academic time. In order to have really great citizens, good citizens, happy, productive citizens, we have to teach social emotional learning.
Social media and other social aspects really, you know, tell kids to do one thing, but this kind of goes against that nature. And to see kids really like tell each other like, hey, that wasn't kind, you know, be nice to each other. It was amazing. It was great to see just the, you know, the building up instead of the tearing down.
I think it's kind of like a guiding principle for like everything you do. Like no matter what, like that can, you can apply that to literally every part of your life.
Yeah, in school and your family and at home, wherever you are. Being kind is the number one thing.
And it could be something simple or something big, it doesn't matter, but one act of kindness never goes unnoticed.
It's like a ripple into the world, and it encourages other people to do the same thing.
Kindness isn't really an attribute, it's a skill set. These skills are broad enough that they fit not only in our character education and in our comprehensive school counseling, they fit in our academic work and in those requisite skills that help them bridge to that next critical skills tier where they can really be innovative and they can be quality contributors. They can be students that are able to engage in effective ways with the tasks that we put in front of them.
The more we bring it in, and if we start with the littles and we keep doing it, by the time they graduate from high school, we could see huge differences.
Live Kind is about living your best life. And that's not just for our kids, that's for our staff as well.
And really just showing kids that it's not just within the classroom, you can branch out into the community and you can branch out past the community. To live kind is not just, you know, where you are at that moment, but it's in everything you do. And so I hope our goal in Inspire is that what we live as teachers and admin, that it goes out to the kids as well, and that they see it in us, and so they'll want to do it, and it'll just be contagious. Because everybody's a role model to somebody.